I call to order the April 17th meeting of the Brentwood Board of Aldermen. If you'd all rise and join me with the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Roll call, please.
Alderman Kramer.
Present.
Alderman Leahy.
Here.
Alderman Lockmiller.
Here.
Alderwoman O'Neal.
Here.
Alderman Plufka.
Here.
Alderwoman Sims.
Here.
Alderman Weggie.
Here.
And Alderman Dimmitt.
Here. Okay, item number three on the agenda is the approval of tonight's agenda. Are there any changes or additions to tonight's agenda? I have actually one suggestion. If somebody would like to make a motion to move item number 18A1 to new business under item 20, I think that's probably a more appropriate place to take up that item.
So moved, Your Honor.
Second.
It's moved and seconded that item 18A1 be moved to item 20A. Any discussion? Seeing none, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Are there any opposed? Great. Any other changes? Alderman Weggie.
So I don't think this is a change to agenda, but I do plan to bring up the dog park memo in new business. So I don't think we need an agenda item for that, but
okay.
Mentally prepare yourself.
Mentally prepare yourself for 20B, dog park. Are there any other changes to tonight's agenda? Okay, seeing none. If there's no objection to approving by acclamation, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Great. We'll approve it by acclamation. Item number four, consideration and approval of the meeting minutes of April 3rd, 2017. Are there any changes or amendments to the meeting minutes? Alderman Dimmitt.
Mr. Chairman, I noticed on page one, as down Alderman Weggie as being absent and Alderwoman Sims as being present. I think it's supposed to be flipped.
Reversed.
Right. What are we talking about?
April the 3rd. You weren't here.
I thought Alderman Weggie was absent.
I was not here.
I was sick.
And Alderwoman Sims was here.
Oh, so we missed two. Okay, so Alderwoman Sims would be absent on that one, on page one.
You were absent as well?
No, Alderwoman Sims was.
Or was that, I thought that was the March meeting.
No, it was the last meeting, wasn't it? You were gone?
I know, but
you don't recall when you're.
No, we can neither confirm nor deny the presence of Alderwoman Sims.
Well, I thought it was the March meeting.
And Mr. Chairman, the only reason I say it is because throughout the minutes, it has Alderwoman Sims as being absent on all the votes, and Alderman Weggie as being yes on all the votes.
I was here on the 3rd.
You were there on the 3rd.
I was here on the 3rd.
So I am going to guess what happened is that Alderman Weggie was absent, as I know he was. Alderwoman Sims was here, but we accidentally used Alderman Weggie's name throughout the minutes in place of Alderwoman Sims.
And then on page 10, it has a yes for both of them.
Oh, well, that's convenient.
So we've kind of covered all the bases, all the possibilities.
Oh, okay.
I don't know who was here.
Let me suggest this. If the board would entertain the idea of letting staff review those minutes in conjunction with the videotape and correcting them, we can go ahead and approve them at the next meeting. So maybe a motion to table until the next meeting.
So moved.
Second.
All right. All in favor of that motion, say aye.
Aye.
Are there any opposed? Great. We will table the approval of the April 3rd minutes until May 4th?
5th? First.
May 1st.
May Day.
Thank you. A note there. Item number five on the agenda, certification of the election results. Before we start this, we have a very short agenda tonight, and we have cake and punch out in the lobby. There are two ways that we can proceed with this. We could either, after the swearing in, we can take a short recess for cake and punch and then reconvene. Or we could just press on with the meeting and have cake and punch after at the board's pleasure. So it doesn't matter to me, but I would like to sort of get a straw poll of how the board feels about that.
Let's get the meeting through.
Press on. Yeah.
Press on. All right. So we will be going through the agenda in its entirety. Then we will have punch and cookies, or cake, sorry. Punch and cake for everyone afterwards. Item number five, certification of the election results. Madam City Administrator, do you have the results?
Thank you, Mayor Thornton, I do. Results of the April 4th, 2017 election results as certified by the St. Louis County Board of Election Commissioners are as follows. Mayor of the City of Brentwood, Christopher A. Thornton, 893 votes. Municipal Judge of the City of Brentwood, Patrick Dignam, 1,375 votes. Alderperson Ward 1 of the City of Brentwood, David Plufka, 477 votes. Alderperson Ward 3, City of Brentwood, Steve Lockmiller, 382 votes. And Alderperson Ward 4, City of Brentwood, Thomas Kramer, 230 votes. And I can't read. Alderperson Ward 2, City of Brentwood, Brandon Wiggy, 351 votes.
I was waiting. I thought maybe you know.
Approach to Ward 2.
No respect.
Thank you.
Well, I'd like to thank Judge Dignam for giving us all something to shoot for. I thought the way we would do this is if Judge Dignam doesn't mind, I would swear him in while I'm still the mayor, then let him swear me in and swear in the rest of the folks, if that'll work for everybody. So without further ado, I'll swear in Judge Dignam.
Oh, I'll let you raise your right hand. Raise your right foot, stand on your left.
I need the oath.
This is the long arm of the law reaching out.
How long is that for you? Is it really?
Do you don't think there's
I got the one from last year, if you want.
Oh, okay, well then, Steve has.
Is that
it? Good job, Steve.
There you go.
Do you have your own?
Just for you.
All right, there.
Kate's getting cold.
Repeat after me. I, Pat Dignam, do solemnly swear.
I, Pat Dignam, do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution and laws of the State of Missouri.
And the Constitution and the laws of the State of Missouri.
And the ordinances of the City of Brentwood.
And the ordinances of the City of Brentwood.
That I will faithfully demean myself in the office.
That I will faithfully demean myself in the office of Municipal Judge.
For which I was elected.
For which I was elected.
On the 4th day of April.
To which I was elected on the 4th day of April, 2017.
Thank you. Congratulations. Raise your right hand. I will.
Higher.
He's fine. I, Christopher Thornton, do solemnly swear.
I, Christopher Thornton, do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the laws of the State of Missouri.
And the laws of the State of Missouri.
And the ordinances of the City of Brentwood.
And the ordinances of the City of Brentwood.
That I will faithfully demean myself in the office of mayor.
That I will faithfully demean myself in the office of mayor.
To which I was elected on the 4th day of April, 2017.
To which I was elected on the 4th day of April, 2017.
All right, let's do a numerical order. Ward 1.
Do it by prime numbers.
Prime numbers. 1, 3.
1, 2, or 3.
1, 2, 3, you're right.
Goodness.
Did you raise your right hand?
The results didn't come out.
Repeat after me. I, David Plufka, do solemnly swear.
I, David Plufka, do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution and the laws of the State of Missouri.
And the Constitution and the laws of the State of Missouri.
And the ordinances of the City of Brentwood.
And the ordinances of the City of Brentwood.
That I will faithfully demean myself in the office of alderman.
That I will faithfully demean myself in the office of alderman.
To which I was elected on April 4th, 2017.
To which I was elected April 4th, 2017.
In my mind, in my heart,
it's not every day you get elected.
That's true.
It was a tough campaign.
Nailed it. nail biter.
You know, if I wore a tie, I should fit this.
You couldn't tie it.
You should be
there. Repeat after me.
I, Brandon Wege, do solemnly swear.
I, Brandon Wege, do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution and the laws of the state of Missouri.
And the Constitution and the laws of the state of Missouri.
And the ordinances of the city of Brentwood.
And the ordinances of the city of Brentwood.
That I will faithfully demean myself in the office of alderman.
I will faithfully demean myself in the office of alderman.
To which I was elected on April 4th, 2017.
To which I was elected April 4th, 2017.
Steve Lockmuller, do solemnly swear.
I, Steve Lockmuller, do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution and the laws of the state of Missouri.
And the Constitutions and the laws of the state of Missouri.
And the ordinances of the city of Brentwood.
And the ordinances of the city of Brentwood.
That I will faithfully demean myself in the office of alderman.
I will faithfully demean myself in the office of alderman.
To which I was elected April 4th, 2017.
To which I was elected April 4th, 2017.
You raise your right hand, please.
Yes, sir.
I, Thomas Kramer, do solemnly swear.
I, Thomas Kramer, do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution and the laws of the state of Missouri.
And the Constitution and the laws of the state of Missouri.
And the ordinances of the city of Brentwood.
And the ordinances of the city of Brentwood.
That I will faithfully demean myself in the office of alderman.
And that I will faithfully demean myself in the office of alderman.
To which I was elected April 4th, 2017.
To which I was elected April 4th, 2017.
I also want to take this opportunity to congratulate our three new school board members, Keith Ravenberg, Lindsay Spencer, and Dan Berlay, who were elected on April 4th as well. I think the school board and the Board of Aldermen will be working quite closely together for the next couple of years, and I'm very happy to say that we have a very fine school board to work with, and I look forward to working with them. So. Item number 8 on tonight's agenda, we have two proclamations. The first is the proclamation of Local Government Week, April 30th to May 6th, and I've asked Alderman Kramer if he would read the proclamation.
Yes, sir. Be happy to. In recognition of Local Government Week, whereas local governments in the state of Missouri make important decisions that affect the lives of all Missourians, and whereas local governments are the level of government closest to the people, and whereas local governments include city councils, county commissions, school boards, among others. And whereas local governments are the ultimate expression of grassroots democracy, and whereas local governments play an essential role in the quality of life in Missouri communities. And now, therefore, I, Christopher Thornton, Mayor of the City of Brentwood, do hereby proclaim April 30th through May 6th, 2017, Local Government Week in the City of Brentwood of St. Louis County, and urge all Missourians to join in recognizing local governments as they serve their communities.
All right, thank you. Obviously, local government, very important, and you know, hopefully you got a good example of it right here. The second one we have is probably even more important. It's without which, this is a position without which local government would not work. This is where the rubber really meets the road. It is a proclamation proclaiming Municipal Clerks Week. And Alderman Kramer, if you'd be so kind.
Surely, Your Honor, in recognition of Municipal Clerks Week, whereas the Office of Municipal Clerk, a time-honored and vital part of local government, exists throughout the world. And whereas the Office of the Municipal Clerk is the oldest among public servants, and whereas the Office of Municipal Clerk provides the professional link between the citizens, the local governing bodies and agencies of government at other levels, And whereas municipal clerks have pledged to be overmindful of their neutrality and impartiality, rendering equal service to all persons. Whereas the municipal clerk serves as the information center on functions of local government. And whereas municipal clerks continually strive to improve the administration of the affairs of the office of the municipal clerk through participation in educational programs, seminars, workshops, and the annual meetings of their state, county, and international profession organizations. So therefore, whereas it is most appropriate that we recognize the accomplishments of the office of municipal clerk, and therefore I, Chris Thornton, mayor of the city of Brentwood, do hereby recognize the week of April 30th through May 6th, 2017 as Municipal Clerks Week, and further extend appreciation to our municipal clerks and to all municipal clerks for their vital services they perform and their exemplary dedication to communities they represent.
Thank you. So anytime you get a chance, do something nice for our municipal clerk. Yes. We don't have any public hearings this evening. We don't have any bids this evening, but we do have a hearing of any matter of public interest upon the request of any person present. If anyone would like to come forward and address the board, please do so. State your name and address, and you'll be given 3 minutes. Good evening, Mr. Williams.
Good evening, Mayor. Good evening, members of the board. And congratulations to those of you who just got a new term. The discovery of the bogus bomb at the Brentwood Rail Transit Station on Saturday night reminded me of a conversation I had on Election Day, as a matter of fact, with a Brentwood police officer. And I wanted to share it with you because I think he has a good idea. And I'm sorry I don't know his name. If I did, I'd attribute the idea to him. It's not mine. But he was saying that in light of the pretty chronic shoplifting problem we have in that section of Brentwood, a lot of the shoplifters come in by train. He was saying that maybe what the city of Brentwood should do as a joint demonstration project with the Bi-State Development Agency to have a big Jumbotron TV screen. As passengers are getting off the train in Brentwood, and they can see themselves as they're alighting from the train, they can't help but see this large TV screen, and they realize that they are being filmed. And he was saying that perhaps that would cause some of these people to think twice about going on up the stairs to Deerberg's or DSW. I understand DSW, I think, or one of the shoe stores is the biggest target. And sadly, Brentwood has the distinction of having perhaps the worst shoplifting problem of any of the, I think, 39 rail transit stations in our region. And a lot of it owes to the fact that the most homeless people and the most felons live in downtown St. Louis, between the homeless shelters and the St. Louis Community Relief Center, the state halfway house, also known as the Honor Center. And there's this big concentration of these folks, and the word got out that the best place to go to shoplift is Brentwood, because you can hop on a train for free, avoid the fare, and maybe get as far as Brentwood before you're going to get busted. It's harder, for instance, to go out to Fairview Heights to the shopping center out there. So the Brentwood police officers can tell you more about this than I can, but it's a pretty well-known fact that there's a real pattern between shady characters getting on the trains for free downtown and riding west to Brentwood, and then they come here and they shoplift. So I thought that was an interesting idea to maybe put folks, everybody who gets off the trains, on notice that there are cameras there and they're being filmed. Thanks.
Thank you. Would anyone else care to address the board this evening? Going once, going twice. All right. We have no unfinished business. We have no bills this evening, which takes us all the way down to item number 18, which is reports of committees and department
17.
Heads. 17. My fault. Thank you. Item 17, accounts against the city. I, Alderman Dimmitt, we have a warrant list.
Yes, we do, Mr. Chairman. I've had an opportunity to go over the warrant list with our city administrator. And I think the one in front of you, though, the hard copy, I don't think that is the latest one, is that correct?
That's
that is
correct.
Yes. That is the latest
right.
one, okay. Then I would recommend approval of the warrant list in the amount of $61,429.34.
Second, Your Honor.
It's been moved and seconded that the board approve the warrant list in the amount of, that was just stated. I lost that amount. Is there any discussion? Alderman Plufka.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I'd have a question for Alderman Dimmitt having to do with the entry of April 1st, 2017 from State Mechanical. Can you give us a notion of the history of the payments that we've made? This is for preventative maintenance, not for any problems with the fire station, but with preventative maintenance of the, and remind me, is it a DICON? Is that the
right.
name of the system?
Well, let me pull out all the paperwork that I have on that, Alderman Plufka. Thank you for doing actually, I do need some clarification here from our city administrator. The one that was emailed to me, the warrant list, was in the amount of $72,054, but the one that we have the hard copy of is $61,000.
Right. So there was another item on the warrant list for Cook & Riley. Cook
right.
& Riley is the law firm that was asked to do the citywide sales tax report. I wanted them to be able to present that report to the board before we would pay their invoice, which was why I pulled that off the agenda. They will
okay.
be here on May 1st to present their the report, and then we'll have the invoice on the warrant list that evening. So
oh.
we took that off.
Okay, so we're sticking with the 61. Okay, thank you. Alderman Plufka, my understanding is on the State Mechanical, which is the, it's the very first item for the board, it's the April quarterly HVAC preventative maintenance contract. Is that the one that you're talking about?
It
is. My recollection, based on some information that I received from staff today, is that this relates to the preventative maintenance for the firehouse. And it, by way of history, there was a memorandum that was sent out in February of 2016, giving us the history. And the original history is that Vogel Heating and Cooling was providing the preventative maintenance at around cost of about $2,000 a year. And then we had to, because of the type of a system that it was, and the city wasn't happy with the work that was being done by Vogel, that they had a different company come out, and that was around $5,600 a year for preventative maintenance. Then we shifted to the present company, State Mechanical, which is the same company that does the preventative maintenance for the rec center. And that cost, though, is around $22,000 a year for preventative maintenance, and it's going to go up in 2018 to the amount of, I think, $24,000.
And am I right that the HVAC system that is in the firehouse is the same one that's in the rec center?
That's correct.
And so I guess I bring this up at this point only because I'm kind of surprised by the jump that Alderman Dimmitt describes between $2,000 and $22,000 in the space of about 24 months. And I wonder if it might be appropriate at some point for the board to take action, at least to look at whether or not, as I understand it, the last bid that came in was one company that bid.
That's my understanding. There was only one company that responded.
And I wonder out loud if that is something having to do with the uniqueness of the system, insofar as there may be not that many local contractors willing to do the servicing of this kind of a system. And I wonder, again, out loud, if whether or not we might be better served by, in the long run, either making some change to the system or expanding the scope of our bids to include sort of a regional bid on the idea that maybe somebody from another city nearby who's familiar with the system might be willing to provide this maintenance at a cost of less than $22,000 a year, even including travel time. Because we're not talking about repairing problems, we're talking about troubleshooting, and we're talking about, you know, maintenance. I don't know, that was on my mind, and that's what I wanted to say, so thank you very much.
Mr. Chairman.
Alderman Dimmitt.
to Alderman Plufka's point, again, the memorandum that was supplied to me is that the preventative maintenance lasts around 5 to 7 days to do this amount of work. And I think what you're wondering is it possible to open the bid back up to some company? I don't know if the companies that we if when we did the request, the RFP or whatever it was it just simply limited to the St. Louis area, or was it more of a regional area? Because when we're talking about that amount of time, it might be more efficient for, might be cheaper for us to have somebody come in and do it than spend the $22,000-$24,000 a year, because over 4 years, that's $100,000 simply for preventative maintenance.
That's it exactly. That's what I'm thinking.
Okay. Alderman Leahy. I'd
like to talk about Mr. Wagon's tree bill.
Okay.
To work with. I find it rather fascinating that Mr. Wagon can have four trees taken out at about 50% the cost of what it was going to cost the city. And we went out for bid. So I question how good a bid we got and how good the service is if the same company that we have the bid from to do our trees and we're doing 100 trees, we don't get a discount for having 100 trees. This man can do 5 trees and still come in cheaper than what we could. So I think it's a good deal that the city has worked out with Mr. Wagon in order to try to rectify a mistaken judgment. But I raise the issue that the cost just don't seem to be right. And as a steward of the city's money, I'd like to see us do a better job with it.
So it's a motion to hire Mr. Wagon then to remove trees.
At least to do the negotiations if he can get us some better costing.
Yeah, I noted the exact same thing when I read the summary of the materials, and I do know that we went out to bid on that one. I guess it looks like Director Grunenfelder's his hand went into the air. He may be able to assist us in this matter.
Oh, it is what it is.
We no, can't win.
I can tell you that one is SMD, who is the tree service who bid on this, did not bid on our tree service. So we don't have their competitive bids. We bid out to anyone, so they could have bid on our process. They chose not to. Couldn't tell you why. I can also tell you that when I talked to Mr. Wagner about his bids, he said that basically, SMD service was very hungry. They've not had a lot of work during the winter. They don't do a lot of work in the winter. They bid very, very low. They undercut. The workers on site said they lost their shirt on that deal. They said they weren't going to do any more work in the winter because they lost their shirt on that deal. So they undercut to try to get some work in the winter, and it cost them. So they undercut that one deal because they were trying to get some work in the winter, and it cost them. So they got a really great deal for 5 trees. You weren't going to get that sort of deal on a continual contractual basis.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Okay, is there any further discussion on the warrant list? Seeing none, let's have a roll call. A motion on the table is to approve the warrant list in the amount shown on page 2, 3.
Page 2.
Go ahead.
Alderman Dimmitt?
Yes.
Alderman Kramer?
Yes.
Alderman Leahy?
Yes.
Alderman Lockmiller?
Yes.
Alderwoman O'Neill?
Yes.
Alderman Plufka?
Yes.
Alderwoman Sims?
Yes.
And Alderman Wiggin?
Yes. All right. Unanimously approved that we pay our bills for another month. Let's see, that brings us to item 18, which is reports of committees. Under my report, I just have a couple of quick things. First, I will be making committee appointments at the second meeting in May, because the first one is coming on the first of the month. So I think we will do the committee appointments at the second meeting in May. I will, in addition to be appointing the alderman committees, I will also be appointing representatives to the Board of Trustees for the library. I will also be appointing one or two new ARB members and several members to our 353. So to the extent that you have an interest in serving on an aldermanic committee or changing your post on an aldermanic committee, or you know people who would be willing to serve on any or all of the above, please let me know as soon as you can. I will probably have a rough draft of those together in early May to sort of talk around to you guys, and then, like I said, finalize it for the second meeting in May. So, like I said, any input that you have on those would be very welcome, and
I look forward to hearing from you. The second thing I want to talk about is we have called, or I am going to be calling, a special meeting of the Board of Aldermen on the 13th of May, which is a Saturday. We'll have the meeting in a workshop format similar to what we've done in the past. We're going to have it over at the rec center, and we're going to start, I think, around, what, 8:30 in the morning? Mm-hmm. 8:30 in the morning. The idea is to discuss a lot of the projects that we've been talking about in terms of possibilities. Flood control, Brentwood Boulevard, Great River Greenway, all these rather larger projects that are going on, maybe even a little bit of dog park discussion, but the focus is on the big picture. And given where we're at in the comprehensive plan, and giving that we've got some good feedback now from that process, even though it's not quite finished, the goal would be to lay out kind of a priority list, if you will, or sort of a longer term plan for, hey, this is what we would like to accomplish in the next 3 to 5 years. These are longer term projects, et cetera, and kind of put some thought into that. So looking forward to that meeting quite a lot. Already have a lot of good materials. Just took delivery of some more today. I think it'll be very valuable, and I'm looking forward to having everybody there. The third thing on my list is on May 31st, Ameren has been kind enough to invite the Board of Aldermen to a ball game at their suite. They asked me to invite you all, so I am publicly inviting the Board of Aldermen to a ball game on May the 31st. So if you would, let me know by email if you can attend. Unfortunately, the suite is not the large, it's the smaller version. So spouses, plus ones type thing, not included. So just the alderman, the mayor, and probably the city administrator. We might be able to wrangle in a city attorney or a treasurer, I'm not sure. we'll see how that goes. But anyway, I think it will be a great kind of team building thing for us to do together, and I very much appreciate Ameren inviting us to do that. Last thing. If you notice, there are some cookie crumbs and some candy wrappers on the floor. There's a couple of juice box straws in the back. That's because the McGrath fourth grade was here this afternoon. And for the last 2 years, I brought over the fourth grades from McGrath and from Mark Twain about this time of year to do, they're studying city government. They're studying government in general. And they take a field trip down to Jeff City where they study state government, they go to the Capitol. And we invite them over here for the afternoon, and we actually have a mock board meeting. And so we elect a few of the fourth graders to be aldermen, and they come up and they sit at the alderman table, and we actually discuss an issue and then take a vote on it. And all the way we're kind of learning how these things work and how ordinances become into being and so on and so forth. And I enjoy the heck out of it. I think the kids enjoy the heck out of it. I think they actually learn a little something in the process. So if you get a chance, I think that video just went up this afternoon on YouTube. So feel free to watch that. I think you'll be pleasantly surprised at how much the discussion mirrors the discussion that takes place in this very room on some of the bills. What if we don't spend so much money and save more money and things like that? And we could do that. So it was really a lot of fun. Our guests will be the Mark Twain fourth grade tomorrow, and I'm looking forward to that as well. So anyway, I think that's all I've got under my report. Public safety, Alderman Plufka.
Thank you. We meet this Thursday, April 20th, here at 5:30.
Thursday, April 20th, 5:30. Just a heads up on that. I think the ARB is going to move their meeting forward. They're going to be in the conference room?
No, we will be in the conference room.
Okay, so the Public Safety Committee will be meeting in the conference room.
Okay.
Because the ARB is going to have to meet at 6 o'clock so that everybody can get over to the middle school for the concert at 7.
Very good.
Yeah. Mick Jagger's going to be there. It's going to be great. Public Works, Alderman Leahy.
Public Works next meeting is Wednesday the 10th of May at 4:30 here in the main council room.
Thank you.
It is open to the public.
All right, 10th of May, Public Works. Planning and Development, Director Kirkmeyer.
No report.
All right. Ways and Means, Alderman Dimmitt.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Our next meeting is going to be May
Fourth?
Fourth.
Yes.
Yes.
Fourth. Thank you.
Thursday. All right, May 4th for Ways and Means. Mr. City Attorney?
No report, sir.
All right, thank you. Madam City Administrator?
No report, sir.
All right. Mr. Excise Commissioner?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. We have in front of us an application for a special use permit by McGrath Elementary PTO. This is for their annual auction. It's set actually for this coming Saturday at Mary Magdalene. This is an annual event, and they've asked for a temporary liquor license. I would move for approval of the special use permit.
Second, Your Honor.
It's been moved and seconded that the board approve a special use permit for the McGrath PTO for this Saturday. Before we have discussion on that issue, I just have a little more information for the board. So this event's been going on for a number of years, and it's traditionally been held at the Masonic Hall in Webster, right behind the police station. This year, at sort of the 11th hour, Father Jack offered to allow the event to be held in the Mary Magdalene gym, and they have air conditioning now, and it free of charge. So basically, the PTO could save themselves several thousands of dollars by moving the venue at sort of the 11th hour and took advantage of that. So that's why that's coming to the board so late. So anyway, is there any discussion on that? Okay, seeing none, all in favor of approving the special use permit, say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Are there any opposed? Great, unanimously approved. Madam Library Liaison.
No report.
And I don't have anything from the Municipal League. Nothing from the Historical Society, thank you. Are there any announcements? Alderman Lockmiller.
I would just like to thank the people of Ward 3 for putting me back in the seat, even though they didn't have much of a choice. And I would like to invite them all to our Ward 3 meeting Tuesday, April 25th, right here at 7 o'clock. Thank you.
Tuesday, April 25th, Ward 3. And anybody else who's interested? Any further announcements?
Yes.
Oh, right. Sorry. Alderwoman O'Neill.
Ward 4's meeting will be April 25th at 6 o'clock at the Brentwood Forest Clubhouse.
All right, April 25th as well, Ward 4 at the clubhouse. Any other announcements? Seeing none? New business.
Waiver.
Yeah, so I think I'm going to ask that someone, Alderman Dimmitt perhaps, since this falls under your committee. The folks at Schnucks called me several weeks ago and indicated that they were being charged a late fee for failure to pay their taxes on time, very similar to a matter that you guys took up when I was actually on vacation. This being a little bit different, they apparently were able to produce evidence that they had in fact mailed the check, and that we in fact never received it, but they produced a check properly dated. They produced evidence that it was mailed. They also produced evidence that they canceled said check after the fact. And once they were sort of informed that we had never received it, they promptly made payment due. So, you know, I guess what I would do is I would entertain a motion to waive the fee for them and then have discussion and see where that goes with the board.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I think the city attorney did a great job of putting together the memorandum explaining the justification for waiving the late fee. And so I would make a motion that this board waive the business license late fee.
Second.
Okay, it's been moved and seconded that the board waive the business license late fee for Schnucks. Is there any discussion on the motion? Alderman Leahy.
I'd like to request that the motion be amended.
Okay.
I'd like it to specifically establish that the waiver of the fee is based on the fact that the check released never was received by the city of Brentwood and is suspected to be lost in the mail system. Thus we start establishing a real good criteria as to why we would consider taking such action.
Okay, I'll take that as an amendment.
it's going...
I'll second that amendment.
Okay. We have a motion and a second to so amend the bill, the motion. Is there any discussion on the amendment? The amendment is to specifically include language of the circumstances that the check was mailed and that it was suspected to be lost in the mail. Okay. All in favor of the amendment, say aye.
Aye.
Are there any opposed to the amendment? Okay, we're back to the main motion, which is the waiver of the business license fee. Any further discussion? Okay. All in favor of waiving the business license fee for Schnucks, say aye.
Aye.
Are there any opposed? We will waive the business license fee for Schnucks. Karen, I'll let you take it up with them. Yep. Item number two under new business. We've been fair warned. Alderman Wege.
So I wanted to bring to the board's attention. So we have in the packet the memo that Eric put together, kind of based on the, you know, the meeting that we had, the feedback that we've gotten from the town. The action that was taken at Public Works on the April 12th. I was hoping to get that on the agenda for tonight so that the big board could vote on that. But it's my understanding that we still need the Board of Aldermen to give the authorization to proceed with the Planning Design Studios, correct? So, you know, if you look at the timeline that Eric has put in here, you know, the critical path on this schedule is really having Planning Design Studio design the dog park, and we're talking about the interim location at Hanley Park. Understand if there's any MSD criteria or anything. So I think it behooves us to move out on that authorization tonight so we can get them working on that. I'm not as worried about the funding for the total amount, but I'd just like to get PDS moving because it's already been a month and 4 days since we had that meeting with our 70 people that showed up. So I'd like to start moving. So I'd like to make a motion to authorize Planning Design Studio, or authorize staff to turn on Planning Design Studio to start this study for the temporary design or dog park.
Second. Okay, it's been moved and seconded that the board authorize staff to issue a work order to Plan Design Studio for the preliminary design of the dog park at the Hanley Park location. Is there any discussion? Alderman Leahy.
Your Honor, thank you. I'm not opposed to a dog park. I'm opposed to the process that we're using to get this one tentatively or permanently established. In the bill that came through the Public Works Committee, we're talking about coming up with maybe up to $300,000 and hiring a design studio. But I think that from historical, the city might do better and save the city expenditures. If we look at the alternative tentative locations and have the conversation with MSD first, we may find that some of the tentative locations, and specifically the Hanley Park, may not be acceptable for MSD to allow us to do it. And I'd hate to incur a design studio design for an area that may be ruled out. So I think that we should look at the process that we're using and not let our hearts dictate how to get this project going. I would also like to know if we are looking at putting in the dog park as a tentative or as a full-fledged permanent location, because we haven't done anything to work in that direction yet. We talked about tentative over the Norm West, but we haven't really resolved. And would the designs include restrooms and everything that would needed to be put in for not only the users of the park, but also the dog park people that would be going in? And would that be part of the bills? The last point that was submitted to Public Works was to look to come up with extra cash without effectively handling the capital projects in the 2017 budget. And I'd like to know how this project jumps ahead or fits into the, I believe it's 80 capital improvement projects that the parks have identified in their master plan, and where this one fell in its range, and if it justifies jumping in status to work with. Under the timeline that was provided, you're not going to do any construction until December. So if we slow down and do a little advanced thinking, I don't think we hurt ourselves, but we may end up saving some cash and our process.
Alderman Plefka.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I'd be curious from the alderman to understand what objections MSD has to this location. To be more specific than that, I have other points to make before you respond. Secondly, I don't really see the logic in hurry up and wait and wait and then wait more. I really don't understand that. If the timeline is December, and that's what's been fleshed out in this memorandum, I don't really see the benefit at this point of waiting further to then give ourselves some idea of whether or not this is going to be a temporary location. I think one of the consensus, if you want to call it that, from the meeting that was run by Eric, it was a great meeting, by the way, was that there was this notion that because there were other things being planned for what might be the permanent location of a dog park a decade from now or 20 years from now, that it made some sense to be looking at an interim, if you want to call it a 20-year dog park interim, locations, and that this was talked about as being a viable location, a recommendable location, and a cost-effective location because there's already parking on site, there are already some infrastructure that's already on site, it is centrally located and is easily accessible to most of the city. For those reasons, I don't really understand the alderman's concern with regard to MSD, but beyond that, I would tell you, I would submit that the other concerns are so far outweighed by the benefit of moving forward in this way that I would recommend that we do as Alderman Wege recommends and earmark the money for that design. Thank you.
Thank you. I'd just like to point out that that's 140 years interim in dog years.
Right. Oh, geez. Right.
Alderman Kramer.
Yes, Your Honor. Madam City Administrator, do you have any ballpark idea what a PDS study would cost us?
Yes, I do, Alderman Kramer. In talking to Eric Grunenfelder, we have an estimate of between $35,000 to $45,000, and part of that would include meeting with MSD to make sure that all the requirements are met so that we can move forward with the project.
We would be taking that money from where in the 17 budget?
We haven't determined where in the 17
or where
budget.
We could.
Right.
Okay.
Whether there would be savings in there or whether the recommendation would be to take it from fund balance.
Is it logical to conclude that PDS, the last time my recollection of this topic coming up seriously in the past was back when Jerry Wolf was still alive. And the conversation then had to do with FEMA and SEMA and whether or not fencing could be allowed in a floodway or flood zone when there was a dog park consideration, and that was the pushback. But my recollection was that PDS, and maybe we could check on this, PDS wouldn't turn a report into us without already consulting the knowledge base.
Absolutely.
Exactly. So they would have circled through that and checked it out before making the recommendation.
Absolutely. And okay. If you look at some of the dog parks around us, they are in parcels that those cities, municipalities, have acquired through FEMA SEMA grant, which means, and there are fences around them, so I would imagine that this would be allowed, but that would be one thing definitely the Planning Design Studio would look into as well.
Thank you.
And just to be clear, to my knowledge, all of the property on which we're talking about possibly building a dog park belongs to the city of Brentwood.
Absolutely.
It is not to the city of Brentwood vis-a-vis any kind of condemnation, flood.
Not that particular one.
No.
That's right.
None of the parcels are subject to any of those restrictions as far as I know. Alderman Lay.
To answer Mr. Plufka's questions, we pushed this issue in 2003. And the city came up with, I think we had four or five locations at that time. MSD shot down every one of them because they did not want fencing. They did not want fecal matter in anywhere near their flood areas and their channels. And we ended up having to get an education as to where and what we could and couldn't do, and ended up canceling getting the dog park up and running to work with. Having a phone call by our parks department with MSD seems to be the easiest and cheapest way to go about proceeding instead of paying somebody $30,000 to pull together a report to come back and say, you know what, nice site, but we ran into the following problems. What do you want to do? And I just think we can do a few things to help ourselves without having to spend big money. And I do think it is worth having that discussion before we start hiring engineering firms to design things out to work with. And I'd really like to see why this is such a critical thing that reason doesn't seem to justify taking conservative actions. Delaying it, you're not. You're just doing some research before you make a hard decision.
Alderman Dimmitt.
Is it possible to get an answer to Alderman Leahy's question right off the bat from MSD? See if MSD would say, without spending any money to the planning PDS or whatever it is.
The PDS people work in floodplains all the time. They do all the design for GRG or a lot of it. So, I mean, if there's some some substantial restriction, they're going to know about it.
Well, and I think that would get to Alderman Leahy's concern.
Right.
Is, I understand his point. Is we don't want to spend $35,000 and have.
And we would know the answer to that right off the bat before we got
into I don't even think they're going to put pen to paper. If they know that it can't be built, they won't bill us for a single hour. Yeah.
I think some of the concerns that Planning Design Studio, because they've done this elsewhere, have indicated to the city is in the memo that we provided to the board. At the very bottom of page one, the last sentence starts to say, since the location is in a floodplain, a survey would need to be completed. An additional approval would be needed from the city's floodplain administrator, which is our building official, and MSD. So we're aware of the concerns, but we've never heard what the city experienced back in 2003. But that's a simple phone call.
That's why I made the same
suggestion.
But
we could do that in conjunction with approval from the board to move ahead, rather than waiting another meeting to come back.
Any further discussion? Okay, seeing none, are we ready for the question? All right, the motion before the board is to authorize the city administrator to issue a work order for Planning Design Studio for the design of a preliminary design of a dog park at the Hanley Park location. A vote in favor means you're authorizing, a vote against means you're not. Roll call, please.
Alderman Dimmitt.
Yes.
Alderman Kramer.
Yes.
Alderman Leahy.
No.
Alderman Lockmiller.
Yes.
Alderwoman O'Neill.
Yes.
Alderman Plufka.
Yes.
Alderwoman Sims.
Yes.
And Alderman Wege.
Yes.
Vote passes.
All right, the motion passes. Alderman Kramer.
Your Honor, if I could seek a clarification from Alderman Wege again, just for everyone's benefit, the original, I guess, proposal or direction of the dog park was in an other area of the city, and this is in a more suitable potentially area of the city. If you could just
more central.
Per the Parks Master Plan, it's in Norm West Park. So the concern from residents, and I think what we heard very clearly at the dog park meeting, was that walking across Manchester with your dog is not something you want to do. And there was a desire to have this as a walkable dog park. So this is, you know, the reason we're calling interim and temporary is that Norm West is still the good solution. It's a lot of land, but we got to figure out how to get people across Manchester. And that might be the GRG tunnel. Who knows what that is? But that's what's leading to it's going to be a while before we get that all worked out. And that's where this desire came from. So this would be Hanley Park, just east of basically the pavilion, just east of the sand volleyball courts, that area.
Thank you.
And I'll just say the way these contracts work, folks, is, you know, we may be approving a work order for up to $30,000, but we pay as we go. It's not a lump sum deal. So, you know, they do 3 hours work, they find out that they can't do this, they bill us for 3 hours work. They don't bill us for $30,000. So and Plan Design Studio has been a very good partner with the city thus far on a number of these projects. I think we can trust them to ask the critical questions first, as Alderman Leahy has suggested, and if those answers are negative, then I think we can trust them to not waste the city's money in pursuing something that can't be done. That's just my opinion, but I've formed it over 2 years of working with them, and I think it's probably worthwhile. Okay, any further new business? Seeing none, I'm hearing one vote for cake and juice.
you are correct, sir.
Item number 21 on the agenda, hearing of any matter of public interest upon the request of any person present. Would anyone else care to come forward and address the board? Okay. Seeing none, we have no closed meeting tonight, and I would entertain a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Second, Your Honor.
Somebody's got to second it. We can't all move it. All in favor of adjournment, say aye.
Aye.
Are there any opposed? Nope. We're adjourned.